Welcome. I am Harjit P. from Center for Information Technology and Instrumentation, Kerala Agricultural University. This video is the part of our initiatives for introducing tools and techniques for content creation for e-learning. Today, let me invite your attention to Open Broadcaster Software Studio, a powerful open source software for video recording and video streaming. Have a look at the screen. The background is a presentation. Text and images are there. And my video is showing in a window within the presentation. How I achieved this? The answer is Open Broadcast Software. As you can see, this is the homepage of the obsproject.com website, and the OBS Studio software can be downloaded from the homepage itself, and Windows, Mac and Linux versions of the software are available. You can download and install the software from this website. You are seeing a screenshot of the OBS Studio application. The elements of its interface are a canvas, a top menu, and tabs like your scenes, sources, audio mixer, scene transition, controls, etc. And we will look into this. And before continuing, please have a laptop with built-in audio and microphone. So we can start the application OBS Studio. My system is Ubuntu Linux, and I am starting this application by clicking on this button. This is the default interface of the OBS application. Its main element is a canvas, and there is a menu, some tabs, scenes, sources, audio mixer, scene transition, and controls are there. The basic element of the application is nothing but scene. We can add several sources to a scene. Here, our target is to prepare a presentation with narrator's video. So, we can first add a video capture device. And I am clicking on the plus button and selecting the video capture device and click on OK. So, my video capture device preview is here, and there are a lot of settings here. Leaving it unchanged and clicking on OK, and I can place that video anywhere in the canvas, and I can resize it to a size which is comfortable for me. Now a video element is added, and next is definitely an audio element. I am clicking on the plus icon and adding the audio input capture device, and then click on OK. Then the default device is selected, and click on OK. Then now you can see that the audio mixer is having a graphical representation of the my audio levels. And we have to add next is nothing but a screen capture element. I'm clicking on this icon and adding a screen capture. Click on screen capture, and it is added now. And the present screen is captured here, and then click on OK. And I need to resize that screen capture to fit into the canvas. And as you can see that the screen capture is now above all other elements, sources, and my video is not showing here right now. For moving that in front of the screen capture, there is two buttons there, up and down, and I am clicking on the down to move that screen capture to behind my video. And now all the elements are almost set, and I am trying to add one emblem, one image here, and I am clicking on the plus button and adding an image, and clicking on that default with the default name. I am clicking on OK, and I am selecting that one emblem from my computer, and it came here, and I am placing it on the right top corner and resize it to a small size. And now all other image sources are set for recording. Now we are ready for recording, and before that we have to open our presentation. And here I am opening a PDF file. This is my presentation I am going to present, and I am keeping it ready and make it as a full screen, and I am returning to the OBS Studio application, and now I am going to start recording, and I am clicking on the start recording button under the controls, and I click on that, then recording is started. I am going to minimize this, and as you can see that the background of my screen is now the presentation, and the doing this presentation and returning to the OBS Studio, and now I am stopping the recording by clicking on the stop record button. Now the recording is stopped. We are going to see the output of this experiment. So here I am clicking on the file item in the menu, and there is show recording item is there, and I am clicking on show recording. Then the folder with that record is opened, and this in the MKV video format. I am opening that. Then the recording is started. I am going to minimize this, and as you can see that the background of my screen is now the presentation, and the video of the narrator myself is shown along with the presentation, and I can explain, and now I am stopping the recording by clicking on the stop record. Yes, we have successfully created a presentation with video narration using the OBS Studio software. This software has a lot of features. All of the features cannot be introduced in this video. So a more advanced session will be prepared and reach you soon. For now, thank you very much. The output video created by Open Broadcaster Studio software has some unnecessary parts which has to be edited and removed. For that we need video editing softwares. There are a number of open source video editing software. We will see one of the video editing softwares later. Thank you.